Just a second. You know, life is fleeting, and someday we will all be gone. For me, that day may come in 50, 60, maybe 65 years if I'm lucky, but I'm not going to be around forever. But this plastic water bottle will outlive me by far. 500, 1,000, 2,000 years from now, it will very likely be sitting in a landfill somewhere. This plastic bottle will essentially live forever. That's not how things work in the natural world. When a living thing dies, Mother Nature quickly gets to work and breaks it down into the matter that it's made of. But not plastic. Plastic nature doesn't recognize. And so after its usable life, it sits and accumulates. I believe we can tackle a big part of the global plastics problem by looking at packaging. After all, last year, 36% of the plastics that were produced went to make packaging materials. 36%. So the goal of my research is to develop packaging alternatives. I do this by looking at plastics on the nanometer scale. Plastics are made out of polymers. A polymer is a long chain molecule that's made of the same unit repeating over and over again. So this is a polyethylene water bottle. Polyethylene and most other plastics begin their lives as a barrel of crude oil. The crude oil is refined into the building blocks for polymers, which are then molded into plastic. So how do we get our head around replacing this miracle material? Well, there's two things I think we need to do. First, the alternative packaging has to perform equally well or better compared to conventional plastics. And second, the alternative has to biodegrade to solve our environmental crisis. So, you may have noticed there are already biodegradable bags out there. These are made from cornstarch. The problem with using cornstarch to make our compostable bags is that corn is a source of food, and so we're going to run into problems in the long run if we start making our plastics out of things that we also eat. But look around it. Look around the world. The world is full of interesting polymers. In fact, most living things owe their form and function to the interesting polymers that make them up. Think of bones or feathers or wood. These are all polymers that are very abundant in nature. Plants, another example. So plants, half of this plant's dry weight is made of the polymer cellulose. About a fifth of this plant's dry weight is the polymer xylan. What if we could use these polymers to make our plastics instead of cornstarch or crude oil? Turns out cellulose makes excellent plastics already. The cellophane you see making up the candy wrappers, cigarette filters, scotch tape, all prime examples of what you can make when you modify cellulose. And all three of these are biodegradable to some degree. So what about the other polymer I mentioned, xylan? Well, nobody's making plastics from xylan yet, but I hope to change that. The focus of my PhD is developing bioplastics from this material, which is abundant in nature and gives materials like wood their strength. So it must make a good bioplastic, right? Here's what I've been developing in the lab. This is a xylan-based packaging that I came up with after many iterations of different plant xylans, additives, processing conditions, and I then went to mechanically test them to see how they compared to what was already out there. So it turns out that this bioplastic is 4 times as stretchy as a typical brown paper bag. It's also twice as strong as the industry standard for low density polyethylene. So that was good news. Then we went to an aesthetic appeal study where we asked trained panelists what they thought of the bioplastic. Panelists liked its transparency. They liked that it was flexible. They liked how it was soft and conformed to the shape of bread. However, many panelists flagged the yellow color of the bioplastic, citing it as unappealing. So I had to go back to the lab and do more work. I borrowed a trick from the papermaking industry used to whiten paper. And sure enough, it changed my starting material from yellow to white. Using the exact same processing conditions as I did before, I formed the xylan into sheets, and Grastic, bioplastics from grass, was born. Look at that. It's transparent, flexible, aesthetically appealing, and no longer has the yellow tinge. So we're very excited to develop this further. So what's going on now with Grastic in the lab? Well, we're currently testing its biodegradation, mixing Grastic with soil and compost, and measuring its degradation products over time. We've found that in about 2 weeks, it seems to be completely biodegraded, and that's very good news. When will you see Grastic in stores, you may ask? Well, let's see. I'm looking for venture partners to help me de-risk and scale up this technology. So who knows, by 2023, Grastic could be well on its way to commercial demonstration. So back to this plastic water bottle. If this had been made with Grastic instead of polyethylene, it would have nature's recycling stamp on it. And it wouldn't persist in the environment as long as plastics currently do, making for a more sustainable future. Thanks very much.